What it is, Punabiz, y'all, GrooveMasta Dre here. Sorry I've been on a bit of a hiatus. Too much has been going on with me, but I'm back, though. I'm back, and we are back at Grapplin, baby. It's Grapplin with the GrooveMasta. All right. Let me tell you what it is, Punabiz, y'all. Oh, my goodness. I tell you, I had a good time over at the Windjammer at Isle of Palm, South Carolina. It was a good show. Had a good time. My only gripe was that when I was trying to do commentary, there was this pillar that was in the way. But, you know, the way they try to have things set up and whatnot, that's just a minor gripe. But other than that, though, I had a good time. I enjoyed Isle of Palm. It was lovely. I tell you, I enjoyed, you know, hanging out with the good folks here at Isle of Palm. You know, I enjoyed the matches that was presented. You know, it was a good show. You know, despite that the weather was a bit cloudy and whatnot, but it was all good, though. It's all good. Anywho, ladies and gentlemen, I did see some great matches over there. Like, there's a tag team match. I think there was a four-corner tag team match, I believe. Four-corner elimination tag team match. It was END, Washington Bullets, The Revolt, which is consists of Zane Riley and Caleb Conley. And then there's this tag team of Josh Powers and Sleaze. They call themselves Just the Tip. Okay? Just the Tip. And you know, there's going to be so many folks, you know, trying to make a meme out of that. Just the Tip. Okay? Now, I know on the pre-show that Brett and Brett Wolverton and Bob Keller, they're both trying to play who's on first. It's like, it's Just the Tip. That's their name, Just the Tip. And you know, they're probably thinking to themselves, look here, better say that name right. All right. I'm pretty sure that I was told, please say that name right. Please say that name right. I am trying. You know that. Oh, my goodness. Anywho. Anyway, that match was good. You know, I saw so many great folks up in here from, you know, Tracer X, Bret in Paradise, and Kevin Phoenix on that on a triple threat match. Originally, it was supposed to be fatal four way match, but Francisco wasn't there at the time, so it turned out to be a triple threat match between Brandon Paradise, Tracer X, and Kevin Phoenix of OSCW Heavyweight Championship. And and I tell you, it was a pretty great match. Yeah, good match, I will say. Then we have I know we got some other matches here and there and whatnot. But anywho, I can't remember exactly off the top of my head, so I apologize for those. Let's see. Well, I know there was a tag team match with Gangrel and Kevin Thorne. All right. So congratulations to them. They won, by the way. And By the way, two lovely ladies of OSCW had a good match. Great match, mind you. Probably the match of the night was Savannah Evans taking on, or should I say Savannah Evans defending her OSCW Women's Championship against cheerleader Melissa. That was the match of the night for me. I enjoyed it. I enjoyed calling the match. It turns out that they became new, you know, excuse me. Turns out that cheerleader Melissa is now the new OSCW Ladies Champion. So, you know, all I got to say is that, you know, congratulations to cheerleader Melissa. And great shout out to Savannah Evans. And by the way, very, very funny. I saw the turnbuckle cupcake where, you know, some guy was getting ready to eat it, but then Savannah Evans showed up and she's like, you ain't having my cupcake now. Let me get a bite of that myself. Oh my goodness, that was just too funny, just seeing Savannah Evans, you know, going after that cupcake. And I tell you, it was awesome. You know, I haven't had a turnbuckle cupcake as of yet, though, but just by the look of the commercial and all that, it seems very, very appetizing. It looks absolutely delicious. My, oh my. Anywho, had a great time, you know, checking out the matches over at OSCW. I love OSCW, y'all. Big shout out to Joe. Alright. Big shout out to Joe. Shout out to Skyler, John Skyler. Oh, I forgot to mention John Skyler and Austin Theory. When I originally done a bit of a promo for that, originally I wanted to say there's going to be a rematch coming up. And I was told, you know, don't mention the rematch. Chances are so-and-so may not come. But, you know, just as I noticed, Austin Theory is here, you know, was there at the time. So I could have kept that in and said, we got a rematch coming up. And, you know, it could have worked. But, you know, card subject to change. It is what it is. But, hey, it was pretty good. We were about to have that rematch for the Intercontinental Championship as John Skyler defend his title against Austin Theory. But then, I think somebody interfered. I forgot which tag team was it, though. Oh, my goodness. But I'll have a look at it, you know, sometime in the near future. So, hopefully, they'll hit me up on something with the Windjammer show, too. I'll probably get to it as I go through it. Oh, my goodness. And by the way, I was trying to do commentary. It was pretty good. I could have had my audio setting towards, you know, to make it plausible or passable or something like that. But unfortunately, though, for some circumstances, it didn't turn out right where I wanted it to be. So, pretty much, you know, it wouldn't turn out too well. And you know what the funny thing is that I was trying to do commentary with cheerleader Melissa, but that didn't happen. That did not happen, unfortunately. I mean, we gave it an effort, but it's all to it as go through it, you know. But I did have some fun, though. Big shout out to cheerleader Melissa. I appreciate, you know, taking time with her, you know. I really do. I really appreciate taking the time to hanging out with cheerleader Melissa. It's absolutely wonderful. I really do appreciate her. Let's see. Let me go ahead and give a few shout outs to many, many other wrestlers that was there at the OSCW show. Country Jack Brady Pierce, Wrestle Force heavyweight champion. Big shout out to him, as well as Eric Darkstorm. Also, shout out to Kevin Phoenix for giving me a couple of his shirts, both 3X. Really appreciate that. I enjoyed it. I'm actually been a huge Kevin Phoenix fan ever since, you know, when I first met him. And I tell you, make a long story short, you know, me taking a visit over to the Village Pizza, back then, about years ago, I will say that, he was very cool. I told him I was doing Throwback Thursday, I was doing radio. I didn't know he was promoting a wrestling show at the time. I was like, okay, I didn't know. At the time, I didn't realize it was actually OSCW. Like, wow. I knew local wrestling exists, but I never realized it existed to an extent. So that's why it took me, I don't know, years later to actually take that moment to go to one. So I'm like, okay. Because at the time, I was so focused on being, you know, just pro WWE at the time. You know, I just wanted to, let's just say, I just wanted to be at the top of the mountain at the time. So, you know, once you get to that top of the mountain, you know what it's like to be at that top. So I figured, you know, let me go ahead and, you know, see what it's like to go at a local wrestling performance show, you know, just to see what it's like to go to one. I'm like, okay, you know. And around 2016, that's the year, you know, around November 27, which is my birthday, by the way, I went to WWE at North Charleston Coliseum. I had a bit of a cheap seat up there, and, you know, had a good show up there and whatnot. But then I compared that to going to next week's show, which is a local show of OSCW, which is my first show being there. I just came in as a fan, and I tell you, I was blown away. I didn't realize that, you know, when I checked it out, it was amazing. I didn't realize that I went to OSCW, and then I realized, I look at the table, I look at some tables, I didn't know there were wrestlers right behind it. They were like salesmen trying to sell you something. I'm like, okay, that's cool, I'll buy it. Then I take pictures, and all of a sudden, I tell you, it was absolutely incredible. First professional wrestler, you know, I got to meet was Chris Masters, you know, and it was incredible. I got to meet Chris Masters, so it was awesome. Oh, and by the way, Chris Master went to TNA, and I think he changed his name to Chris Adonis, I believe. Anywho, sorry I had to get off track, y'all, but, you know, I'm just showing y'all how much I appreciate, you know, hanging out with Kevin Phoenix. He was, believe it or not, I didn't know he was a wrestler at the time because I met him over at the pizza shop. He was working there. He showed me that there's a wrestling show coming up. And I was like, cool, I'll think about it. At the time, I didn't know where it was because, you know, being that I only been to South Carolina for about what, 8-9 years at the time, I should have been exploring all over by now, but I didn't realize, you know, where it was at the time. So I decided to hang on out, you know, I think years ago, starting at, as a late birthday gift, one of my high school friends decided to take me one. And lo and behold, there was over at my first OSCW show in Hanahan Rec Center, and Hanahan, that was my first show that I ever came upon, and it was cool. I didn't know what to say about that. It was absolutely incredible, you know. Yes, indeed. I enjoyed the show. I love it. That got me hooked. Alright. I will say that. But anywho, again, shout out to Kevin Phoenix. Much love to him and the rest of the END, TJ Boss, Zucker King, Nick Kismet, Willie B. Who else? Tracer X, the X-Man himself, the X-Factor, the Independent Variable, Brandon Paradise, and by the way, congratulations to him being a new champion. Also, Sleaze, Josh Powers, you know, many, many different wrestlers within the scene. Austin Theory, shout out to him as well. Also want to give a shout out to folks behind the scenes as well. Katie Sparks, hope your leg gets feel better. Hope your legs get to feel better soon, Katie. All right. DCT, which is the ladies of Becca and Taylor. Shout out to y'all too. Carrie Keller. Let's see who else. Also, you know, so many different people I want to give a shout out to, but you know, just hit me up if you want your name to be noticed within this podcast of what it is upon the biz, y'all. Alright, you know, grappling with the groove mess and all that. Hey, I'm just letting you know what it is on the biz, alright? Let's see, what else? Well, I tell you, I enjoyed OSCW, and not too long ago, I went on Facebook, and OSCW recognized me as one of their top fans, along with a few others. So I had to give big thanks to those over at OSCW for recognizing me upon that, because I wanted to continue to promote their shows, you know, whenever they have a show coming up. Believe it or not, in June, there's going to be a show called Cage Carnage at the Hanahan Rec Center. And believe it or not, Tommy Dreamer is going to be there. So I'm looking forward to checking out the Innovator of Violence, Tommy Dreamer, to be there over at the Hanahan Rec Center for Cage Carnage of OSCW Old School Championship Wrestling. And I'm looking forward for this. All right. All right, so here we are. We got our superstar shakeup right here on hand. We have Rey Mysterio on Raw. We have Aleister Black on Raw. We have Ricochet, AJ Styles, The Miz, Eric and Ivar to Raw. They're known as the Viking Experience, really? Well, at least a week later afterwards, they are known now as the Viking Raiders. But for some anomalously reason, one of the moves now is called the Viking Experience. Wow. Okay. Cedric Alexander to Raw. That's a big thumbs up right there. Andrade, Zelina Vega on Raw. Naomi, Lacey Evans, The Usos, Eric Young, and EC3. They're all on Raw. And then going to SmackDown, we got Roman Reigns, Liv Morgan, Finn Balor, Heavy Machinery, Otis and Tucker, Bayley, Kairi Sane, Elias, Lars Sullivan, Buddy Murphy, Mickey James, Ember Moon, and Chad Gable all went to SmackDown. And all I can say is this, is that those are pretty nice changes, but they ain't going to last long because recent news been breaking out is that Zelina Vega and Andrade went back to SmackDown, and reason being is that because one, Charlotte's on SmackDown, and Charlotte and Andrade are in a relationship. I think they were engaged, I believe. And so is Zelina Vega and Aleister Black. They're pretty much dating with each other. I think they're married. I'm not sure. But I know that there was a bit of a connection with them. So, yeah. And yeah, at least they got to stay within that relationship. Let's see what else. Well, that's pretty much the only thing that is known for as of right now. Alright. That's the only thing I could think of at this moment. Okay. Let's see. What else? What else? What else? Yeah. So that was the bit of a shakeup that I was just looking at and all that. And I tell you, it was pretty worth it. I enjoyed the shakeup, was pretty good. And that's pretty much all I can say from there. But other than that though, the shakeup was pretty interesting. And you know, can't wait for the new feuds to come on out. I can't wait to see, you know, AJ Styles versus Seth Rollins for the Universal title on Raw, which is going to be interesting. What else? Also, there's going to be, I believe Becky Lynch is going to defend two belts in one night, which is pretty amazing. I believe she's going to defend it against the Raw Women's title, going to be defended against Lacey Evans, and the SmackDown Women's title will be going up against Charlotte Flair, which so many folks are really, really getting tired of that. They get real tired of that. You know what I'm saying? But at least we got Lacey Evans in the fold within. So we're going to see what's going on with it. Alright. But anywho, that's pretty much all I'm going to point out for WWE at the time. But other than that, though, I do want to say thank you all very much for tuning in to Grapple with the Groovemaster. Make sure you like, subscribe, ring the bell for future uploads, and just keep moving and grooving on up, showing us some love like diamonds on the rough. Alright, thank y'all for watching, and remember, it's not how good the groove is, it's how you be grooving good up in your neighborhood. Until next time, this is the Groove Master coming at you. Groove Master Dre saying you are grappling with the Groove Master.